this time. It is Living the Run. We're not just chewing the fat, we're getting rid of it. We are your home for everything health and fitness. Living the Run is being brought to you by Running Warehouse, CrossFit Grover Beach, Artie's Pilates, and in partnership with the American Cancer Society and the Heal Slow Coalition. Here are your hosts for Living the Run, Ryan Ferran and Paul Terek.
Living the Run, Health and Fitness Radio on ESPN 1280, The Ticket. Happy one-year anniversary to Living the Run. Happy birthday to us. Thrilled to have survived 1 year on ESPN 1280 and Living the Run. We are thrilled to still be here. This is the big show for us. We're very excited to have made it this far. It's not easy getting sponsors and all that sort of thing to survive a year in these tough economic times, as we all know about. But we're very happy to be here. We'll get to the thank yous in a moment and let you know what and who is on tonight's show. But we really do appreciate everyone's support who has supported Living the Run, either sharing some of our links on Facebook, helping us get out the word, inviting us to speak at their some of their mixers and things like that. I just spoke for the San Luis Obispo Realtors Association on Tuesday, which would be yesterday. So we appreciate people like that helping us get the word out, and you, the listener, for showing your support for the show and showing that you do appreciate a unique show like this, because this is a little bit of a different format, especially for ESPN Radio, 1280 The Ticket. So we appreciate Mike Chelson and the guys here at ESPN for taking us on and getting us to our one-year anniversary. So thanks. We really do appreciate it. It's been fantastic, and more thank yous coming up. That's what we got to do. Also coming up, we're going to talk about my meditation experiment. I've done a lot of interesting experiments in the first year of Living the Run. Did a vegan experiment, lasted a week. I tried to go 30 days and could not do it, but I really learned a lot from it and appreciated it. That experiment started from reading the China study, learning about Tony Gonzalez, the famous NFL tight end, who read the China study, went vegan. He actually has his own supplement company now that's pretty sure it's all vegan-based, protein and all that sort of thing. So I've done the vegan experiment. I went 2 months with no dairy. My no dairy experiment. That was not as hard as the vegan, obviously, because I lasted a lot longer. But no cheese, no yogurt, no milk duds. That's the sacrifice I make for you people. 2 months with no dairy. And I did that to try and clear the sinuses that have been stuffed up for the past 2 years, thanks to allergies and that sort of thing. I wrote all about that on livingtherun.com. Didn't see any difference in removing dairy from my diet after 2 months. A lot of people say you'll see your sinuses clear up in, you know, just a couple weeks, maybe even a week, if that is the issue. But I'm back on the dairy, loving the cheese, milk duds, crushing those when I can. On occasion, though, everything in moderation. This is a health and fitness radio show, after all. What else did I do? I tried the, speaking of allergies, I tried the honey experiment, eating local honey. That didn't really work either for me. My success rate is pretty low.
Is that like one of those ideas where you get a shot or vaccine where they introduce a little bit of the disease to you so your body becomes accustomed to it and knows how to fight it in the future?
Exactly. That's the theory behind that. And we had Karina Corral on from KSBY talking about, she did a story about that and talked to some doctors and investigated that. Pretty, I wouldn't say, you know, deep, but she did a, you know, pretty in-depth story on that. And some of the doctors she talked to said there's really no validity to that. Some people swear by it, though. And Avila Valley Barn, I was talking to somebody there, and they said, oh, yeah, people come here all the time for the local honey to help with their allergies. So I think it may be one of those things where it's, you know, by the time the 2 or 3 months passes that you've been taking the local honey, your allergies kind of pass as well. But yeah, Max, you hit it right on the head. And that's Max Woodcock, our producer extraordinaire, by the way. Yeah, that's kind of the idea. You get you know, a subtle hint of these allergens in the air through the bees, through the honey, and then your body builds up an immunity to them so you don't get the allergy responses that you typically would. That didn't work, so tried that. What else have I tried? I think there's one other. Oh, I tried the clean diet. Clean diet detox, which is a pretty hardcore diet. What was that one? No sugar, no alcohol. I don't know if dairy, I don't think you can do dairy on that one. You can only eat certain meats. Oh, you start the day with basically a fruit and veggie shake. You end it with a fruit and veggie shake or a soup. You only have one solid meal a day. One solid meal a day for you people? Are you kidding me?
Did you try that juice diet?
Yeah, and I did a juice fast. That was before the radio show, but I did a 36-hour juice fast. And I was just reading an article on juice fasting that says that they don't recommend it. Some people swear by it. That's one of those controversial things. That got a lot of comments on livingtherun.com about some people swearing by it. Some people saying it's not the brightest idea in the world. I did it. I liked it because you just have a certain period of time, however long you choose to do it, where you're just bringing in fresh vegetables and fresh fruit. None of the junk, none of the preservatives, no high fructose corn syrup, no hormones in the meat, no junk. You're just bringing in fresh fruits and vegetables, and it's just juice, so it gives your digestive system some time to relax and clean out and do other things and detox. So
what was the reasons the scientists gave behind it being a bad idea?
I'm trying to think. I know the whole protein issue, and there's some people, depending on their medical conditions, that should definitely never do a detox. And there's a few medical conditions, I can't think of them off the top of my head, but they should definitely never just do a strict juice fast. So it is interesting. There's two sides of the coin on that, because people swear by them. They do like an annual retreat and they'll go to these detox centers and just have nothing but juice and that sort of thing and they'll do them for, you know, maybe a week at a time, 3, 4, 5 days.
I mean, because I can totally see one of the things with the veganism as well is a lack of B vitamins, just because of the proteins that you're not getting. You're not getting those certain amino acids that your body needs to produce certain things. So I could see where that would be bad, but I mean, vegans kind of counterfeit that with the idea of, hey, you can supplement yourself with the B vitamins that you're missing and the certain amino acids that you don't get from protein. So in the case of juicing, you know, you're not getting certain vitamins and proteins, but there are supplements out there that do act as a way of counterproducing that, I guess, in a way. So why, I guess, what is the overall reasoning behind it could be bad for you?
You know, that's a, I don't know the, some people have different reasons on that as far as, you know, and I know the protein thing's big, but, you know, just living off of juice, that's not exactly what we've been doing for.
Put some solid food in your body,
exactly.
People.
Exactly. So, and especially, you know, they recommend you don't do, you know, strenuous exercise and that sort of thing when you're fasting. So that was one of the other things I tried. But the other one I recently tried was meditation. And this is one of the ones I think I'll definitely stick with. Never really done it before until a few months ago. Tried it once. Wasn't really successful at it. So I'll talk about kind of my experience with that. And, you know, I've talked about this on the show before with you and Paul. Paul, MIA, by the way, our 1-year anniversary. Paul Tarek, a no-show.
What a shame.
Unbelievable. And I was going to say nice things to him. This was going to be the... You know, we finally made it to a year point, and I had one or two nice things to say to him, but forget it. He doesn't even show up. He had to work. He told me he wasn't going to be here, but man, what a show to miss. So I'll discuss my meditation experiment, and this is one of the experiments that I will definitely stick with, give you some tips how to get into it. And this is one of the things I talked to the Slow Realtors Association about and talked to some people afterwards, and they were kind of interested and had some good points on how to get into it. Because when you first start meditation, it's hard, very hard, to sit with your thoughts alone for 1 or 2 minutes and just concentrate and not have your mind wander. And there's the whole thing, how do you sit and what do you listen to and that sort of thing. So I have some good tips how to get started if you're interested in it, want to bring those stress levels down, get the anxiety out of there and just kind of relax and get away from our hectic, fast-paced lifestyles. We're also going to talk to the race director, Mitch Massey, from the Heritage Oaks Fun Run coming up Sunday, September 25th. And we're also going to talk a little football. We were both covering the, actually, there's three of us in studio that were at the, covering the AG Lompoc High School football game on Friday night. Max was there as well for ESPN Radio. They had the game. I was there for KSPY. Back on the old boob tube for the first time of the year. That was fun. And so that was a great game. AG goes up 21-0. Lompoc gets a late kind of nothing touchdown first half to make it 21-7. So it's 21-7 at the break. And then Lompoc 38-1, outscoring the Eagles in the second half. Pretty exciting game. So we'll talk to Mitch about that. We'll talk to Max, who was there as well. We gave away 5 free minutes on Living the Run on our one-year anniversary. And I think we're going to do this each month. We put it out on our Facebook page. So if you want to find out details how you can get 5 free minutes on Living the Run, the only health and fitness radio show on the Central Coast, not many nationwide either. If you have a good cause, you know, maybe you're have a great charity that you're working for, putting together a race for, or you have a good story to tell or interesting topic you want to share about, something you experienced, you tried veganism, you tried this, you tried that. We're going to give away 5 free minutes once a month, have you on. Our first winner is an ultra runner from the San Luis Obispo area. I put it out there and he said, I'll talk about my failed attempt at running an ultra marathon. And fail is kind of a relative term. He still made it 55 miles. But he had to pull out. I was reading his blog today, which is very well written. And his name's Cody. And talking about the nausea and throwing up. And because we've had some ultra runners on and some darn good ones. Dean Karnazes, the most famous ultra runner. He was on our show twice. He's written a few books. Has a DVD. We talked to Thomas Rice a couple weeks ago. He recently did a 100-mile race. And they've had their issues. Dean Karnazes was, he went night blind. He went blind, basically. Was crawling to the finish line. So we'll hear from Cody about the misery of trying to complete a 100-mile race.
55 miles is failing. I feel like I am a failure. I know. For my whole life, I have failed.
That's why I point out that his words, not mine, because you do a 5-mile race in my book. That's amazing. But he trained for it. It was kind of, you know, he was disappointed, but a lot of those people, that's why it's so amazing. And we hear all the success stories, but there's a ton of people that toe the start line and do not finish because it's a 100-mile race. You're running for over 24 hours straight. And that's if you're fast at it. I mean, it's incredible. You're trying to eat, drink, stay hydrated. You're peeing on the run. I mean, you got to put your body through just something it's never been through before. So we'll talk to him about what he learned, how painful it was. And we'll kind of, we'll be like the you see the car accident on the freeway. We'll talk to him. We'll slow down and see, take a look at the what happened to him. What else do we have? We have our Malahi 4 text trivia contest. Last week, we had, well, it's going to be the same concept this week. Name that famous athlete trying to sing. Last week, who was it last week?
Mr. Manny Pacquiao.
That's right. Manny Pacquiao. Sometimes, I won't even do it. He was singing Sometimes When We Touch. And it was, you know, even more out of key than myself. And it was pretty hilarious because he really does want a singing career and he's taking it seriously. And we're talking about, it's really hard to make fun of Manny Pacquiao because he's pound for pound, probably the best boxer ever to have stepped inside the ring. So this week we have another famous athlete trying to sing. And this one, I don't know, it may be a little easier than Manny Pacquiao getting it last week. So we'll get to that in a minute. Our Malahi 4 text trivia contest. The number to text in, 242-1280, 805-242-1280. The summer sales event at Malahi Ford in Arroyo Grande going on now. They have more cars and trucks in stock than ever before. Malahi's policy is that they will not be undersold. So come in today and drive home in a new Ford car or truck, knowing you got the lowest price on the Central Coast. Check out MalahiFord.com. So the first 3 people to correctly text in will win prizes. Only 1 text per person and no computer use. People who have won from us in the last 6 months are not eligible. First place winner will get an Artie's Pilates Power Pack from Artie's Pilates in Pismo Beach. It includes one private lesson with Artie, four group classes, Power Pack valued at $190. Our silver and bronze finishers will both get a one-month membership to WeStreamFitness.com. WeStreamFitness.com has hundreds of real gym classes that you can log on and take at any time. You can choose from Pilates, yoga, kickboxing, the always popular tab class, thighs, abs, and booty. Plus, they have live trainer chats and discussions as well. The text trivia contest brought to you by Malahi Ford, where good things are happening. We'll give you a little taste before we go to break. After that, we will talk about my meditation experiment and to Mitch Massey about the Heritage Oaks Fun Run coming up September 25th in Paso Robles. We'll also get to our 5 free minutes. And I think that's plenty to get to. Then we'll get to our thank yous for living the run. But let's get to this, our Malahi Ford text trivia. This famous athlete trying to, and the air quotes are up, sing. Let's get a little piece of this, Max.
The ramparts we watch with so gallantly streaming.
I think Jim Rome plays that like every 5 seconds on his radio show, just that little uh-oh when something crazy happens. So who is that famous athlete trying to sing? It's our Malahi Ford text trivia contest question. 805-242-1280. Name that famous athlete trying to sing. First three in win. 242-1280. We'll be right back after this.
You're listening to Living the Run on ESPN Radio 1280 The Ticket.
Do you want to take a gym class but don't have the time? Or maybe you just don't want that smelly guy dressed in his 80s gear hovering over you in yoga class? Again, WeStreamFitness.com has more than 200 real-life gym classes that we shot and recorded, and they're available to you whenever and wherever you can log on. Choose from Pilates, yoga, Zumba, kickboxing, aerobics, or our always popular tab class, thighs, abs, and booty. Plus, WeStreamFitness.com offers live chats with trainers and other wellness experts. Full access is all yours for just $15 a month. So whether you're tired of that same old boring workout DVD, or you're tired of smelly yoga guy, check out WeStreamFitness.com. We stream to keep you lean.
If you're on the bench, get on the phone to a sports medicine specialist at Sierra Vista Regional Medical Center. Call us if it's torn, broken, strained, sprained, aggravated, aching, pulled, bruised, swollen, dislocated, or hyperextended. Sierra Vista Sports Medicine Specialists, the choice of Cal Poly Athletics. For a free physician referral, call 800-483-6387. That's 800-483-6387. Sierra Vista Regional Medical Center. Top rate from top to bottom.
Running Warehouse is the fastest growing running store in the nation for all major brands of running products, including ASICS, Brooks, Nike, Saucony, Mizuno, New Balance, and Adidas. Running Warehouse is focused on providing runners the best shopping experience available online, on the phone, or in our store. Running Warehouse offers top-notch customer service, an outstanding selection, an easy-to-use website, low everyday prices, plus free shipping and returns on deliveries made within the 48 contiguous states. Find out for yourself why Running Warehouse is the fastest-growing running store in the nation. Visit us online or stop by our retail store in San Luis Obispo on Suburban Road near Trader Joe's. Smart runners save cash at runningwarehouse.com.
Ryan Ferran here. Listen. Mortgage rates are still at all-time lows, but are climbing. Before they go up higher, make sure to call my friend Chris Orsini to refinance your home. Chris's reputation for honesty and integrity are unquestioned, and there is nobody in the mortgage business that I would trust more to handle my finances. Whether you need a purchase money or refinance loan, call Chris at 440-4288 or email him at chris@chrisorsini.com. That's O-R-S-I-N-I. Reference Living the Run, and Chris will pay for your home appraisal at the close of escrow.
Artie's Pilates Studio in Pismo Beach is a Pilates-only studio that uses the full line of Pilates apparatus. Whether you're rehabbing an injury, want to strengthen your core, relieve back pain, or just increase your energy and overall fitness, Artie's Pilates Studio has it all, including a full staff of trainers who are nationally certified. They offer private and semi-private lessons, plus group classes on the Pilates Reformer. Artie is even certified as a Pilates golf conditioning specialist. Artie's Pilates Studio in Pismo Beach. Call 773-3863.
A preventable epidemic in the U.S. is killing our family, friends, neighbors, and children. Over two-thirds of American adults and 34% of kids are overweight or obese, which can lead to diabetes, heart disease, and premature death. 56% of adults and 32% of 5th, 7th, and 9th graders in Slo County are overweight or obese. Healthy Eating Active Living San Luis Obispo Coalition, or Heal Slo, wants to reverse that trend in Slo County. What can you do? Help us fight the epidemic by joining Heal Slo or visiting www.healslo.com for resources or more information. Together we can work towards a healthier and brighter future for ourselves, our loved ones, and our children.
We're back with Living the Run. Here are your hosts, Ryan Ferran and Paul Terek.
And we are back. Ryan Ferran and Max Woodcock holding down the fort. No Paul Terek on our one-year anniversary of Living the Run Health and Fitness Radio. He is almost being missed. Almost. Our Malahi 4 text trivia contest question. Name that famous athlete trying to sing this song.
For the ramparts we watch, with so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red flag. The bombs bursting.
I can listen to that all day long. 805-242-1280, Malahi Ford text trivia. Name that athlete butchering the national anthem. Uh-oh. Makes me laugh every time. All right. My meditation experiment. We have plenty of text coming in. I haven't checked them all yet, so keep them coming. We still may have some prizes to give away. 242-1280 if you know that famous athlete. Uh-oh. Trying to sing the national anthem there. Meditation. Got into it. Stressed. Anxious. Need to relax, get away from the fast-paced world of Blackberries, iPads, computers, laptops. Max just gave me the stress ball back that I gave him from last week. Thank you, Max. Appreciate it.
Regifting.
Regifting. I like it. This is an expensive regift. Not really. So tried a little meditation. See what it was like. The first couple times was hard. You're trying to sit there, gather your thoughts. How do you sit? What do you do? And I discovered the always popular YouTube videos. There's a lot to sort through, but there are several good guided meditations on YouTube. And I put two of them on our playlist titled LTR Recommends, something like that, on our YouTube channel. So I put two of my favorites on there. And they're basically 10-minute videos, so you know how much time you're dealing with. And they kind of walk you through the process. One is basically just a relaxing, nice soothing voice where the guy kind of leads you through some deep breathing, tells you to relax. You know, if your thoughts start to wander, don't worry. It's very soothing. I fell asleep to it a few times listening to it, so you know it's working.
Is this video called Rocky?
You settle down over there. What's the Russian's name? You forget. What is the Russian's name? Rocky IV. Somebody help me. 242-1280.
I just got through one. Don't push me to four yet.
So anyway, the guided meditation is a great way to go if you're first getting into it. Some people are very concerned about how you're sitting and your posture and this and that. Some people say, lay down, lean against a wall, do whatever you want. I'm of that nature too. However you are best relaxed, That is the whole purpose of meditating. So if you're relaxed, leaning up against the wall, lean up against the wall. Don't worry about trying to sit butterfly Indian style with your back straight through the ceiling. Don't worry about that. But I also recommend, like I said, the videos. Check out the two we recommend on our YouTube channel. And search on YouTube. See which guided meditations you like. They kind of walk you through it. Some you like, some you won't like. Some of the music's a little weird. I actually downloaded on my iPad a meditation app where you can adjust the volume of the music to the voice, what kind of sound you want in the background. So there's pretty cool apps out there, too, that you can use. But I like the videos because you know it's 10 minutes, so you don't lose track of time. You kind of let them lead you through it. You don't have to worry too much about it. And after a while, after you start to do it a few times, you start just concentrating on your breathing, kind of relaxing, mellowing out, and you become less distracted. And even if you do get distracted, it's okay. Just come back to concentrating on your breath and getting back to it. Another thing that I would highly recommend is doing the deep breathing, at least through some of the portions of it, because that has there's a lot more research and evidence now that really does have a impact on your nervous system, brings down your stress levels. You really should be doing deep breaths. A lot of people with anxiety and stress are short breathers, that they call them. They just are shallow. They don't breathe all the way from their stomach and exhale out. You also get all that bad oxygen out, bring fresh oxygen all the way in. And there's a real physical response in your body to that. So even if you don't meditate, do the deep breathing. It really does show a great response physically to your system. So I've tried it. I liked it. I would recommend it. I used to think, again, it was one of those weird things that pot-smoking crazy hippies would do in the middle of the forest. But now doctors, lawyers, real estate agents, your neighbor, a lot of people are realizing the benefits of yoga. And now there's a lot of, not yoga, meditation, although yoga as well. And now there's a lot of research starting to back that up. And I'm far from a Zen Buddhist monk that has mastered the art of meditation, but after a while, once you start to get it down and realize that you are relaxed, less anxious, and it's working for you, you start to go past that 10 minutes and you're like, hey, I don't need to be a crazy pot-smoking hippie, you know, in the middle of the redwoods to do this. So if you're into it, you think you may want to try it, go for it. You have nothing to lose. If it sounds kind of crazy to you, I don't blame you. I used to think it was crazy and odd for years. So not a big deal at all. All right, let's get to, we're going to name that famous athlete trying to sing. Ivan Drago. Thank you. That's who you are. Ivan Drago, Max. Thank you. Oh, and they even tell me who played it. Dolph Lundgren. Thank you, guys. See, that's the support I'm talking about on our one-year anniversary. That's the support I need. Paul Tarek, see, he would have known that. He's not here. All right, one last chance. Malay 4 text trivia, 242-1280. Name this famous athlete, air quotes up, trying to sing.
For the ramparts we watch, with so gallantly streaming, and the rockets ripping.
Uh-oh. All right. We're closing the Malahi Ford text trivia. That is Carl Lewis. Uh-oh. I give him credit, though. He finished, was calm. I probably would have ran out of there, nervous as can be, and just blew it. He stayed there, tried to finish strong.
It's funny, though, when you listen to the rest of that, right after that, he quickly speeds up his singing.
Yeah. And there's another high note at the end where he just totally avoids it. He just basically speaks it. He wants to avoid another disaster. But, hey. You know, he's not a singer. He tried to do the national anthem at an NBA game. I think that was in the 90s.
Just keep holding up that fist.
Yeah, exactly. So, Carl Lewis is your answer to the Malahi Text Forward Trivia Contest question. Thanks to everyone who participated. And again, those meditation videos, guided meditation videos, are on our YouTube channel. Just search Living the Run on YouTube. That's where all our recent shows are as well. When we come back, we'll talk to Mitch Massey about the Heritage Oaks Fun Run coming up Sunday, September 25th in Paso Robles. We'll talk a little bit about the AG Lompoc High School football game on Friday as well. And we'll get to our thank yous on our one-year anniversary on Living the Run Health and Fitness Radio.
You're listening to Living the Run on ESPN Radio 1280 The Ticket.
So, where's the best place to be this summer? Oh, I can answer that. Out front, leading the way with Ford during the Best Place to Be sales event. Ford is only the best-selling brand in America. Cars, trucks, SUVs, crossovers, everything you'd expect from a leader. They've got the Explorer, the brand new Focus, the Fiesta, the Fusion, the Taurus, all with innovative technology. Sync, EcoBoost, Active Park Assist. Of course, everything is very fuel efficient. I'm telling you, the Ford Best Place to Be sales event now happening at Malahi Ford in the village of Arroyo Grande. It really is the best place to be.
What's up? AJ Allmendinger here. When I'm on track, there's nothing more important than having my car in tip-top shape. And you shouldn't settle for anything less either. That's why I recommend taking your vehicle to Malahi Ford for all your servicing needs. Whether it's an oil change, tune-up, new tires, or major repair work, Malahi Ford is the team you want handling your vehicle.
So visit Malahi Ford in the village of Royal Grand and you'll be a winner too.
Malahi Ford, where good things are happening. Stop by today.
Are you looking for a fun challenge this fall? Well, lace up your running shoes and start training because the 16th annual City to the Sea Half Marathon 5K race and Kids Fun Run takes place on October 9th. The half marathon course starts in lovely downtown San Luis Obispo and winds through scenic back roads ending in seaside Pismo Beach. The 5K and Kids Fun Run both start and end in Pismo Beach. For all the details and to register, see the official website, www.citytothesea.org.
Your weekend warrior may take biking, surfing, and other sports to extremes. And when he knows excitement, make sure you know the way to the Sierra Vista Emergency Room. Our professionals are on staff 24/7, boosted by technology and expertise that can help ease the pain of a wipeout. The Sierra Vista Regional Medical Center Emergency Room, ready for you round the clock. Just off Santa Rosa Street at Murray in San Luis Obispo.
Running Warehouse is the fastest growing running store in the nation for all major brands of running products, including ASICS, Brooks, Nike, Saucony, Mizuno, New Balance, and Adidas. Running Warehouse is focused on providing runners the best shopping experience available online, on the phone, or in our store. Running Warehouse offers top-notch customer service, an outstanding selection, an easy-to-use website, low everyday prices, plus free shipping and returns on deliveries made within the 48 contiguous states. Find out for yourself why Running Warehouse is the fastest-growing running store in the nation. Visit us online or stop by our retail store in San Luis Obispo on Suburban Road near Trader Joe's. Smart runners save cash at runningwarehouse.com.
Artie's Pilates Studio in Pismo Beach is a Pilates-only studio that uses the full line of Pilates apparatus. Whether you're rehabbing an injury, want to strengthen your core, relieve back pain, or just increase your energy and overall fitness, Artie's Pilates Studio has it all, including a full staff of trainers who are nationally certified. They offer private and semi-private lessons, plus group classes on the Pilates Reformer. Artie is even certified as a Pilates golf conditioning specialist. Artie's Pilates Studio in Pismo Beach. Call 773-3863.
With Living the Run. Here are your hosts, Ryan Ferran and Paul Terek.
And we are back, Living the Run Health and Fitness Radio. Ryan Ferran, Max Woodcock. We will bring in the race director for the Heritage Oaks Paso Robles Fun Run in just a moment. First, let's get to our Central Coast race calendar. Coming up, speaking of, first race on the calendar, Heritage Oaks Bank Fun Run, Sunday, September 25th, Paso Robles. 5K, 10K, 1 mile race, 5K walk, much more. And we'll get to the details in just a moment. City to the Sea Half Marathon, Sunday, October 9th. That takes place, starts in downtown San Luis Obispo. Half marathon, 5K, and a fun run. And the half marathon starts in downtown SLO and ends in the lovely Shell Beach. For more information or to add your race to the calendar, simply email ryan@livingtherun.com and we will get it on there for you. All right, let's bring in the race director for the Heritage Oaks Fun Run in Paso Robles coming up Sunday, September 25th. And before we get to the race, though, we got three guys in studio that were at the AG High Lompoc football game on Friday. AG up 21-0. Uh-huh. And then that's not how the game ended. It was 21-7 at the half. Lompoc outscored AG 38-7 in the second half. And it was just a fantastic game. Big plays everywhere. And obviously a great comeback by Lompoc. So, Mitch, start with you. What were your thoughts of, I know a lot of people that left after the first quarter, Mike Wozniak.
You dropped a name. First of all, happy anniversary. I had no idea when we were talking Friday on the sidelines of the AG Lompoc football game that you would say, hey, why don't you come on and talk about the fun run, but you were remiss in saying that it was your one-year anniversary. Let me just say that you look as good this year as you did last year.
Thank you.
What was your question again? Oh, the football game.
The football game.
Wasn't that something else? And when you look at Lompoc, it's not like they got back into the game from a standpoint of passing. They simply are a very straightforward team, meaning they're going to run the ball left and run the ball right. They have a couple outstanding running backs. But at the same time, when you look at Lompoc High School and the history of running backs, Sheldon Canley, who played with the 49ers for a while, and he was the Napoleon Kaufman before there was a Napoleon Kaufman, and then Napoleon Kaufman obviously is the greatest high school football player that I've ever seen, one of the best the state has ever had, and he was the top player in the country back in the early 90s before going to Washington. And so they brought back the tradition last year by winning a championship. And so I've just now rambled on and really haven't answered your question. All I know is they did it from a running standpoint. They stayed to it. And down 21-0, they did not diversify. They said, let's keep pounding away, and it definitely defined change in momentum. And it was a fun football game, no matter what time of season you play it.
Yeah, that was a great way to start. They call it week zero for whatever reason, but that was a great way to kick off.
Yeah, why is it week zero when it's actually the first week?
Nobody knows.
I'm in banking, so that whole mathematic thing, I understand zeros, but it's kind of like, we're zero, why not just say one?
Nobody knows.
Then go to two, and... So I guess zero is a number.
That's the mystery.
You can call me a zero if you want.
Of the CIA. All right, let's get to the... No, you're a number one in our book. I mean, how many other guests are we having on under 1 year anniversary?
Well, I don't know. How many others did you ask? And then you got stuck with me.
12. Paso Robles, fun run coming up in a couple of weeks here. What can you tell us about?